Hello everyone, Michael here from the Daily Note 2 YouTube channel, and welcome to another version of Galaxy Note 2 Tips and Tricks, episode 19. Now I'm sure you all remember having scrolling wallpaper on previous Android versions before you got the Galaxy Note 2, if you had a Galaxy device anyway, but for some reason they removed it out of Gingerbread at the later versions, and we haven't seen it on ICS or Jelly Bean. So I'll tell you how to get it back two different ways. First way is to use an app called Landscape Wallpaper. So just find an app in the market called Landscape Wallpaper, install it, and then open it. And when you open it, set your wallpaper image. I'm just going to set it to a picture that I have in my phone, but I downloaded the Quill wallpaper just from doing a little bit of googling, and I put it on my phone because I like the quill picture of the quill, and I made sure it's using all of the image, and then I click OK. And the next step is to start live wallpaper, and it could see that landscape wallpaper, the app that we downloaded, is in the list of wallpapers now. So I just select that. Then the last step is to hit set wallpaper. After that, hit the home button. And you could see that the wallpaper is moving once again, and it is definitely nice to see, but I'll show you that it's not the same. I've moved all the way to the right, but it stops moving once we get to the end of the image. But you could go back the other way, and you could see that it moves all the way until it gets to the end of the image once again. So it doesn't work exactly the same, but it works almost as good. I'll show you another way you could get it. You could get it through you could get it through an app or a launcher, a third-party launcher. For example, your home screen here, this home screen has a name. It's called TouchWiz, and it is provided by Samsung, but you could run other launchers that are in the Google Play Store. So search for the word Nova, and then you'll see this app called Nova Launcher. Just install it and then open it. Okay, after you open it, you might need some setup. You'll see that all the icons that you have on the TouchWiz home screen is not there, and there will be an import feature. So I just did an import. It copied all my icons, but it didn't copy all my widgets, so I had to put all my widgets back in place. And one thing I'll show you, so we're in Nova right now. I'm going to hit the home button and go back to TouchWiz. And you could see that one thing that doesn't make it is this weather widget and this clock. So I'm going to go back to Nova Launcher. You could see I had to find a widget by myself. I just found HD widget. It's another app available in the market. But I found another app that kind of looks similar to it. It gives me more of the weather, but not the clock. So I guess it's a fair trade. One other thing that you might notice is that the application monitor, I did an episode yesterday talking about the great properties of the application monitor. You'll see that the application monitor just updates a little bit more slower in Nova Launcher. So you might cause some false alarms. You might report that an app is having trouble and this turns red. You go into it and you'll see a lot of the times there is no problem inside. So just one thing to keep in mind. Okay, and you know, it's still using that scrolling wallpaper that we set, but actually we could set the wallpaper to what we get straight off the device, right? And then you could get the official wallpaper, and it snaps back. You could see that you could see the quill behind it. Once we reach the end of the image, it actually snaps back to the beginning. One additional good thing about the Nova Launcher is that it does have a landscape mode, and it works actually better than the landscape mode, the unofficial landscape mode that you could force TouchWiz into. It works better because, as you can see, we're in the Nova Launcher, and then and there's no flickering of icons, and in application there's no icons on the bottom that you cannot access. It all works well. Okay, so those are the good things, but there are some drawbacks. As I told you, these two apps, you know, don't work exactly the same, or this one's not available. Well, another thing that you won't see happen is you won't see anything like Page Buddy. Okay, I pulled out the S Pen, but you could see the Page Buddy page didn't pop up. And if you are not sure what Page Buddy is, I'll show you what Page Buddy is. So we're back at TouchWiz. Page Buddy is this. We pull out the S Pen and we get this page. Okay, you might have noticed the same effect when you insert a headphone. But when we're in the Nova Launcher, the Page Buddy page doesn't pop up, but everything else pretty much works the same. You could do a double tap to do a pop-up node. You could crop images there. So everything works the same, except the Page Buddy isn't there. You know, instead of Page Buddy, you could probably just hit the S node app and you get something like it, and it works pretty well. Okay, so that's the end of this episode. I hope you got something out of it. If you haven't been to my channel yet, please come to my channel and check out my other 80 videos on the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe, because I create an episode a day so that you could get the most out of the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. Once again, thank you for watching.